discuss how to handle the debt in Selenium, right? So this is very essential and very important topic in the Selenium. I'll also show you the how to code it, but prior to that we will just discuss few terminologies, or we can say that the logic how we are going to implement it. If this is a calendar control in a web page, so once we click on it, a calendar pop-up comes. In that pop-up we have current month in front of us and the current date highlighted. We might have certain date in our mind to select. It could be prior to current date, or it could be after the current date, right? So now it is very basic thing that if you are going to do it manually, you click on either previous or next would be dependent upon which month you are going to select. For example, today's date is 6th August, and if suppose I want to select a date 5th September 2017, right? So I need to click on the next button once. If I want to select a date in a December, then I have to click on the calendar when it will come September, October, November and December, right? So September, October, November and December. So four times I need to click on the next button. While if I want to select a date in January, so I need to click on the previous button approximately 6 to 7 times, right? So this is very much clear that I must click on either previous or next number of times the difference between my current month and my desired month, right? So for that purpose, very first and basic step is we need to get the month difference, right? And once we get the month difference, we will click on that particular date. So let us see how we are going to do this. When you will click on that calendar drop down, you will see there is a month and year, right? Month in full format and year in YYYY format. So what we will do is we will find out the web element of that particular text and we will get that date. It will be in the string format. We will convert it and we'll get the current month from it, right? Similarly, we will get the desired date in a string format. We will extract the month from it and we will make a difference from it, right? Once I come to know how much difference it is, whether positive or negative, whether my date is previous to my current date or it is next to my current date, so accordingly I am going to click on either previous or next button, right? So once I'll come on that particular month, I'll be clicking on my desired date. So in this way we will be selecting a date, right? So let us see practically how to do this. So let's go to the computer.
So let's start. We'll start with writing a test. We'll write a method, public void test date. Right here we'll write a code to open the browser. Right, so using this code the browser will open and it will be maximized, right? So the date picker we are going to see from this website, right? It is jquery.ui.com/datepicker. Here you can see there is a text box. When I click on it, I can see a pop-up of a calendar, right? Here we have next and previous button. Now we will go to this URL, driver.get the URL, right? So next thing is that I have to click on this, but before that I can see that this date text box is inside a certain frame, right? If you go through the code of it, you'll be able to see it. So you can see that this is a iframe having a class demo frame, and inside this frame there is a date picker. So we must switch to this frame. It is not a big deal, don't worry. I'll show you how to do it. It is very simple. Simply write driver dot switch to dot frame, and inside it find that element, find that frame element, driver dot find element by dot let me see, it is having a class name demo frame. I can search is using by class by dot class name, right? So now I have switched to this particular frame, and the next thing is that I should find this web element text box and click on it. Again, it is having a ID date picker, so I'll write driver dot find element by ID date picker dot click. So this statement will help me to show this pop-up of calendar, since it will click on this text box. Now I must decide which date I need to select. So let's suppose I am selecting a date like 2nd December 2017, right? This is in a string format, and its format is DDMMYYYY. So I must get current month, and should get the month difference between the current month and date to be set. So to get the current month, I should get the XPath of it, this August 2017, and then should use the function getText. So let us see how I can do it. So I can see that inside this due having a class UI date picker title, right? So I can use this class name. So driver dot find element by dot class name, right, dot get text. So I'll get the text, I'll store it in string current date str, right? So this date is in the format MMMM, वाई 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 राइट MMMM वाई 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 सो आई गॉट टू स्ट्रिंग्स आई गॉट टू स्ट्रिंग्स ऑफ डेट टू बी सेट एंड द करंट डेट इन देयर रिस्पेक्टिव फॉर्मेट सो लेट मी कन्वर्ट दिस इन टू अ डेट फॉर्मेट सो फॉर दैट आई I'll create a date object. So date set date is equal to. So I'll be converting on this line itself. So new simple date format. So set date is mmdt. DD MM YYYY. One small tip, never use this YYYY in capital. Dot parse set it. Right? It is going to throw exception, we'll handle it. Using a parse exception. Next is date current date is equal to new simple date format. Current date is in the format MMMM space YYYY. So dot parse current date, right? Now I have got two dates. So let's take a month difference. Int month difference. Now for this we are going to use JodaDate. So in order to use functions from JodaDate, you should download it from the internet. You go search and you'll get this on java2s.com. Download and copy it. Right? So download and copy it into your lib folder. I have already downloaded and copied. So now I'll be writing the month difference. Right? So months dot month between new date time current date dot with a day of month one comma new date time set date with a day of month one dot get months. Right? So this is the function that is going to give me the month difference, right? Please remember that the current date section should be the first parameter and the date to be set should be the second one, right? So we have got the month difference. Now let's check if your month difference is less than zero, means if it is negative, right? So I must convert into positive y because we are going to run a loop. So the month difference has to be a positive, right? We will also set a boolean is future variable. By default it would be true, and if the month difference is negative we will make this is future false. Right? So the next thing is that we will rotate the for loop starting with integer I is equal to 0 till I is less than month difference I plus plus. Now if it is a future date, I'll click on the next button, or if it is a previous date, then I'll click on the previous button. Right? So first I'll check if it is future date. Then what I should do? I should click on the next button, else I should click on the previous button. So in order to find the X path of the next button, I can see that here there is a span having a text next. So if I use a span having a text is equal to next, so I can get my desired web element. So if it is a future date, then driver dot find element by XPath, that is just we have found, span text is equal to next dot click, else it would be the previous one. So instead of next, there would be prev, right? When I am writing it prev, I am getting this previous button. Right, so I've written like this. This is a general code, please remember, don't worry even if your date picker is not from jQuery. This is a basic logic. If you apply this, you'll be I'm sure you'll be able to select any date, right? It is not necessarily, it could be from a jQuery or a jQuery date, right? So shall we run this at least once? So let us see what result it gives us, right? So according to our code, it should open a browser, it should go to the website, it should then switch to the frame, then it should click on the date picker, and then it should find the month difference between the current month and date to be set, and then it should click on either next or previous based upon the month difference, number of times the month difference is. So I'll be running this program. Date picker is selected and the next button is clicked, and we have come till December 2007. So it means that we are okay till here, right? Now the final thing is that we should click on the date to be set. Here we have taken date at 2nd of December, so we must select this date. So let us try to figure out how to get a particular date. So we can see that for any date there is an anchor text, right? So So what if I do A where text is equal to say 2, then the 2 would be selected. So I'll keep this thing variable, right? So I'll copy this XPath. So finally driver dot find element by dot XPath, wherein, right, and dot click. This 2 is a variable, so instead of that we will put a variable, say day. Can get a string day, right? So in order to get this day, we should convert the current, we should convert the date to be set into DD format, right? So let's try to convert it. Day is equal to new simple date format, say DD dot format set date, right? So whatever the date to be set is, from that the day will be extracted and will be stored to the day variable. So let us see what it does. We can see that the XPath has come as 02, but we have a date only 2. So if we convert that string into integer, then it should work. So I'll convert it integer dot parse init of day, right? So it will take that 02 as 2 only. Right, now it has selected the date 2. So this was all about selecting a date from a date picker. So again, I would like to tell you friends that this is a jQuery date picker. Your project may have some other date picker, but don't worry, the logic would be the same, the steps would be the same. Only you need to play with certain XPath and very simple things. And if you have any doubt, any query, you can comment below this video. I'll be happy to answer it. Thank you very much.
So friends, this was all about how to handle a date in Selenium. I hope you get the idea how to do this. I'll be time to time posting these videos regularly. To get in touch with me, please do not forget to subscribe to my channel. If you want to learn Selenium with me, you can come to my place and learn with me if you are in Pune, right? So call on this number right now to get the more details. Thank you very much.
Search for my channel Amol Ujagre on YouTube. To subscribe, please click on this subscribe button and nearby the bell button to get you the notifications. Please click on the send me all notifications so that once I upload a new video, you will get the notification. If you are using YouTube on mobile, then search for my channel Amol Ujagre on YouTube mobile. To subscribe here, there is a subscribe button. Please click on it. Please also click on the bell button to get the notification.